I want to talk for a minute about being preeminent and about a strategy of living your business in a preeminent way, a strategy that very obviously I call the strategy of preeminence. Of the many things I'm best known for in the work I've done in the last 30 years around the world for entrepreneurs and professionals in about every kind of field, the strategy of preeminence is one of which I'm probably most proud. Some of the things that I have developed that I think are still very powerful, and the first is really going to sound interesting. It's an ideology and a mindset, and it's not original, but I evolved it. It's called the strategy of preeminence. Well, that's what I call it. And I learned the foundation when I used to do work with Phillips Publishing, and one time I traded him $500,000 worth of consulting for them letting me visit and interview their key management, because they had a history when they started. They were outperforming their closest competitor, who back then was Agora, by 3, 4, 5 times, and their margins were 3 times as much, and they were commanding higher perception for all their experts in their newsletters and advisory services. And I want to thank you. I wanted to know why. So I deciphered what they were doing. I integrated it, and I tried to evolve. And I came up with this concept called the strategy of preeminence. And anything that I talk about here, including like the letter we sent out to get all the experts to call us, I'll be glad to send you or have Brian send you the strategy of preeminence. I'm not a perfectionist. I've got some transcriptions of when I did it one time that I will be glad to send to you. And I got a video of it that's been edited. It's a little medicinalized, if anybody wants it. But the fundamental elements of it, and we use it for every client we work with and everybody I ever put through any training program, it's a foundation upon which you can build your ideology, your marketing, your advertising, your culture, your hiring, your interaction with all the clients. And I didn't bring anything but a little note, so I'm going to have to remember because I haven't done it for a long time. But the first thing is you want to establish yourself as the most trusted advisor in the category for life. And if you're going to be the most trusted advisor, you've got a moral obligation to give them true advice, not just information. Advice that's in their best interest. As their best, most trusted advisor, you can't allow them to do things that are in their worst interest. And that can mean not taking action. That can mean buying less, not buying the combination. It can even mean buying from your competitor, not because he or she's an ass, but because they are going to underserve them. As their most trusted advisor, the first step you've got to do is you've got to put into words the feelings, the desires, the fears, the hopes that they have gnawing at them but have never verbalized. And when you show them in words that you understand what they're feeling but they've never verbalized, it's liberating to them, and they immediately see you in an incredible connection with them as somebody who really gets them and somebody who can be their benefactor. The next thing, very critical,